The last topic is repair and rehabilitation. Repair is the technical aspect of rehabilitation, refers to modification of a structure partly or wholly which is damaged in appearance or serviceability. Stages of repair. Repair of concrete structure is carried out in the following stages. Number 1, removal of damaged structure. Number 2, retreatment of surfaces and reinforcement. Number 3, application of repair materials. Number 4, restoring the integrity of individual section and strengthening of structure as a whole. So the repair work which we are going to carry in our structure or in the any particular element, so these are the 4 steps which you want to carry over. Step by step procedure has been discussed and we are going to see in detail about that, what are the steps to be carried out in the 4 stages. So stage 1, removal of damaged structure. So example, again coming again to a doctor, if we have any injury in our hands or any part of a body while we are just getting fell down or met with an accident, when we going to meet a doctor, what they do is immediately they will start with the first aid. So what are the process in the hospital they will do is, again the same procedure will be carried out here, removal of damaged structure. Let us see one by one and let we compare with the hospital. Prior to the execution of any repair, one essential and common requirement is that deteriorated or damaged concrete should be removed. So whenever you are doing any repair works, so that part, if it is fallen or some part of the portion will get fallen when we start repairing it, that also want to be removed by means of any equipment or just by any hammers, etc. Removal of defective concrete can be carried out using any tools, that's what I mentioned, and equipments. Normally, removal of concrete can be accomplished by hand tools, that means any trowel or etc. Or when it is impractical of the extent of repair, it can be done with a light or medium weight air hammer. That's what I'm mentioning again and again. So using air hammer, you can able to cut some parts which is can't able to do by your hands. So care should be taken not to damage the unaffected concrete portion. So the important thing is, while we doing or patching any other works, the portion which is not get damaged should be taken care, because if you are doing that, it may also get disturbed and cracks also may develop there. So you want to take care of that, but other portions. For cracks and other narrow defects, a sawtooth bit with help achieve sharp edges and a suitable undercut. So you know that sawtooth kit, so that can be used for the purposes. Next is pre-treatment of surfaces and reinforcement. The preparation of a surface for pre-treatment for repair involve the following steps. Number 1, complete removal of unsound material. Unsound material means, again, strength will be less, or there might be voids between the surfaces, or more voids develop, cracks are developed, etc. Undercutting along with the formation of smooth edges at the point of a smooth edge occurs. Removal of the cracks from the surfaces, by removing the cracks which are the portions which cracks has developed. Formation of a well-defined cavity geometry with rounded inside corners, proper shape to be cut. Otherwise, if you are just clipping it, it may develop more number of pieces, and again the portion which has not developed crack also get disturbed. So you should take care of that. Providing rough but uniform surface for repair, that is the important point. The cleaning of all loose materials and oil and dirt out of the cavity should be carried out shortly before the repair. So example, again coming back to doctor here, when we going to hospital for a first aid, so the nurse will normally take some sponge and with mixing with any chemicals or Dettol, even sometimes they should rub the to remove the sand particles or any glass particles, etc. Likewise, we want to remove the oil and dirt particles before carrying the repair work. This cleaning can be achieved by blowing with compressed air. So we have the compressed blower for compressing some dust particles, minute dust particles may be there that may be disturbed at the time of repair works. So that also to be removed, and hosing with water. So again, it should be the surface to be washed with water once again. Acid etching or by using the help of any acids. Wire brushing, you know that wire brushing normally we use to clean the floorings and all, that can be carried out. And sometimes even brooms or brushes will also help to remove the loose materials, so that if it is in the floor level, we can use the brooms and brushes to remove that also. Next is application of repair materials. After the concrete surface has been prepared, a bonding coat should be applied to the entire cleaned exposed surface. Again, the back example, doctor example, after cleaning with the Dettol with the help of some sponges, etc. And again, doctor will apply some cream over the full surface. Like that, we are applying some bonding coat to the entire surface, okay, that to be exposed to the surface. They used to tell that please leave for some time so that it will get bonding, or some other words they may use. It should be done with minimum delay. Immediately after the water has been washed and blowers to remove after the dust particles, immediately this work should be carried out. The bonding coat may consist of bonding agencies such as cement slurry, cement sand mortar. Depends on the surfaces, those can be chosen. Cement slurry, cement sand mortar, epoxy mortar, resin materials, etc. Depending on the surface or depending on the element, we are going to choose the bonding coat. Adequate preparation of surface and the good workmanship are the ingredients of efficient and economic repairs. So that is adequate preparation of surface, then only with a good workmanship, that is the main thing, then only the repair work will be fully successful. Again, in the hospital, again, after with the help of only good doctors and good nurses, the wound will be get properly covered. Otherwise, if they are not good, the wound may be again exposed, or it may develop and it will not clear, sore, etc. So the main thing is good workmanship is required for the preparation of service. Whenever we are taking care of the repair materials, the problem we are facing is requirement of a good workmanship. If you are getting a good workmanship, then the surface getting repair will be proper in work. And repair procedure. The repair of cracked or damaged structure is discussed under two distinct categories, namely ordinary or conventional procedures. As usual, we have normal procedure will be there and conventional procedure will be there. And special procedures also have been developed nowadays with the latest technologies, latest techniques and newer materials such as polymers, epoxy resins, etc. Again, whenever you are going to doctor, instead of cleaning some methodology, nowadays we are using injection also and to cure the wound soon. And many tablets as giving example vitamin, protein improved, calcium tablets to wound to make the wound soon, to make the wound to be recover soon. So for like that, here also we are having many methodologies, latest tech, newer materials are available. And let me see what are they. A repair procedure may be selected one or more of the following objective. That is so these are the upcoming important objectives. Number one, to increase strength or restore load carrying capacity. So when a repair working is carrying out, it also should increase the strength. Strength means that particular point, due to cracks develop, the stress may be less, strength may be less. Say some stresses, some words will be there. Depends on the material, the stresses may vary. So that stresses to be arrested and the strength should be get increased. To restore or increase stiffness, to restore the cushion to be used. If the flooring is repaired, again when we are repairing the flooring, so that should be reused immediately after a particular time period. To improve the functional performance, yes, that is the main thing, then only we can be able to use the structure again and again. To provide water tightness, otherwise seepage, again we may develop seepage, leakage will be there, so that should be arrested. To improve appearance of the concrete surface, then only the surface will be getting smooth and we have a good aesthetics. To improve durability, so again whenever we are increasing the strength or stiffness, the durability of the concrete structure or any other structure will also get increased. To prevent access of corrosive materials to reinforcement, that is the important part, so that the corrosion materials should be properly planned so that the reinforcement in the structural element will not get corroded. So we can provide some corrosion, anti-corrosion paints, or we have some powders also nowadays, and that can be added with the cement slurry or concrete whenever at the time of working. Next is durability of concrete repair. The objective of any repair should to be produce rehabilitation, which means a repair carried out relatively low cost with a limited and predictable degree of change with time and without premature deterioration or distress throughout its intended life or purpose. To achieve this goal, it is necessary to consider the factors affecting the durability of a repaired structural system as part of whole or a component of composite system. So the objective of repair should be produce rehabilitation, which means it should be done in low cost, because no one should think that instead of repairing we could have constructed a new one. So that much economical should be taken care at the time of repair without disturbing the life of the structure or the purpose of structure already it is in the using stage. To achieve this goal, you should have some durability characteristics has to be taken care at the time of construction itself or at the time of repair or rehabilitation. So some of the findings and recommendation may be grouped into three categories. So durable, number one is durable repair design, number two durable repair application, and number three is evaluation of the repairs. Let us see one by one what are they trying to discuss or explaining us. Number one, durability of concrete repair. Number one, durable repair in design. So in that, again, some factors are there. The first factor is modulus of elasticity and the strength of the repair material. The modulus of elasticity of the repair material not only affects the resultant flexural stiffness of the repair members, but also the tensile stress prevent within the repair material and the debonding stress at the interface when differential movement occurs between the repair material and substances. In the concrete laboratory, normally we have a test named as modulus of elasticity, or Young's modulus, which is used to calculate in the cylinder. So in that part, you may see that. So this statement will be incorporated there. So the repair material should not, the main thing is the Young's modulus of the material should not affect the flexural stiffness. So that is the main thing of the repair members. Not only the flexural stiffness, it means the tensile stresses is also getting affected at the time of repairing. So that also should be taken care. A higher difference in modulus of elasticity between repair material and substance may adversely affect the stress distribution with the repaired composite material cross section and may lead to considerable stress concentration. Therefore, the repair material selected should have similar modulus of elasticity as the substrate as possible. So they, for example, let us consider a wall. We are going to have some patchwork or repair on the wall brick, and for that we have been plastered with some surface. So in some plaster surface may peeled off or spalled. So we are going to again plaster it over. The thing is, the bonding with the new material and the old material should be proper, so that you should know the history of the structure. So what are the types of materials has been used, so that only whichever you are going to use nowadays or now to repair or patchwork carried out, that both the Young's modulus of existing material and the newer material which are going to use now should be of similar. That's what the point mentioned. So then only the bonding will develop. Otherwise, what will happen means cracks may develop, internal cracks, some stresses may also develop. So that's what the point is discussed with us. Next point, thus considering the strength of material alone seems less fact, and over emphasis on strength may cause repairs to experience cracking arising from drying, shrinkage, creep and heat of hydration. So that leads to a less fact also, and repairs to be cracked and also may develop. And next point is coefficient of thermal expansion of repair material. Tensile stresses in the repair material caused by changes in temperature of the surround environment are proportional to the differences in the coefficient of thermal expansion and the change in temperature. So L alpha T, you may study in mechanics of solids or some other subjects also. So that's what is going to impact here, the thermal expansion. As we said or discussed earlier, when considering Chennai airport, the difference inside and outside and again inside itself getting very like that here also. So the stresses in the repair material may cause some changes. Yes, suddenly when you are applying a new material over the old material, there may be some change in temperature, because it may be the sample or solution which you are preparing will be in new temperature. the temperature in the existing structure that we are going to repair, that may be in different, since it is exposed more time to the sunlight or weathering condition, surely it will different. So these two old and new materials will cause thermal expansion that will happen. Therefore, the repair material selected should have same similar coefficient of expansion as possible. So that is very tough to identify that, but even though as per theory we should identify, but in field it is very tough to identify the thermal coefficient of thermal expansion between these two materials. Anyway, it will always get vary. Next is thickness of repair. The internal stresses within the repair material and substance are affected not only by differential movements, not only movements, but also by the relative thickness. A thinner repair layer is more easily cracks or debond. Yes, whenever we are having a repairing a structure with thinner material layer, that is patching work should may be taken with thinner layer by just giving some paint like surface. Let me leave it. So it should not do like that. You should break some other part also, and you should give some deep layer of repair or rehabilitation. Then only the structure will get more good. This one is durable repair design. That's durable. Now it is durable repair application. The first one is the preparation of the repair surface. How we are going to prepare the repair surface? So now we already chosen. Now we want to make the surface, prepare the surface to use. To repair, we are preparing the surface for repairing condition. The most important surface characteristics of the receiving substance are its roughness, soundness, cleanliness and moisture condition prior to the application of the repair material. Example, normally when we are taking any material or any substances, 90%, so let us say 90%, the substance should be dry, then only we will use for testing. Then only we can able to take care of the strength, any other properties example. Okay, so that is to be important thing which we want to consider. The surface should not be wet at the time of taking repair surfaces, and it should be good soundness also. That is the important point. So the first step in the repair to be carried out in the removal of the damaged structure. So when the surface should be dry, then only we can do some patchworks, or you can remove some part of the work where the cracks has developed. If it is wet, we should not do the work. It may lead to collapse also in some cases. Next point, it is very important to select a method most appropriate for the specific in situ condition. That is the important thing. So example, when you may say that one method, say method A, so you cannot adopt the method A in all the condition. Depends on the site condition, you want to choose the particular method which is suitable to this condition. Okay, that is an important thing. If you are taking any method like that, it may damage the structure, or there is no use of doing the repair work also. Any method that weakens the sound concrete and creating micro cracking should be avoided. Micro cracking means if it is exposed to surface, then the shrinkage may develop more. So that material should be avoided. Otherwise, the durability and bond will be decreased by these defects. So commonly used are sandblasting, chipping with jackhammers and hydro demolition, among which the last is highly recommended. A sound surface, if adequate roughness, can be created by this method. So these are the methodologies. Bonding agents. Use of polymer bonding agents is not recommended. That is the main thing. Polymer bonding agents is not recommended, since the modulus of elasticity is different from that of the existing substances. However, use of cementitious bonding, so that is the better methodology normally we are adopting with a low water cement ratio, because high water cement ratio means again it takes more time to settle, or leads to shrink also, or leads to seepage, so that you also should be avoided. Next point, curing of repair material. So we are we want to take care of the curing time also. So excessive loss of water in higher shrinkage and cause debonding failure of the repair material at an earlier stage. So excessive loss of water, again if you are using high water cement ratio, loss of water may due to higher shrinkage, so this may also damage the structure. Therefore, specification of proper curing after completion of the repairing is very important. So whenever we are taking care of any repair methodologies, we will use some chemicals at least, or some powder form in that example, we may say that in X company, okay, doctor fix it. Let us take doctor fix it. So you can see in TV advertisement, doctor fix it advertisements. Okay, so in the doctor fix it itself, in the box or the cover which are purchasing the material, they will mention for 50 kgs of cement you can use 2% of this content, or for 500 kgs of cement use this full box. Like that it will be mentioned. And if you are using mixing with water, so for 1 liter of water take 10 ml of this. Like that they will be giving detailed specification. Okay, that specification should be studied, and then only that combination should be taken for the application. So that's what the next point is explaining is, curing time should be at least same as that of adapted for usual concrete practice to manufacturer recommendations. Yes, after that apply also, the company itself may given some user manual. They may clearly explain us how long it should be, the material should be cured. They will be saying that 7 days, 10 days, like that you want to take the curing time once in a day, twice in a day, like that they will be mentioned. So that should be carried out properly. And the last and third one is evaluation of the repairs. So how to evaluate that? Behavior of the interfacial transition phase. The formation of the transition phase may be affected by many factors. So such as micro cracks and pores may be formed within this phase caused by the differential movements between the substance and repair materials, and a lack of aggregate interlock action between the two materials. So the micro cracks and pores that we want to take care of the repair work. Next is behavior of the repaired structure. Differential movements between the repair material, and they may result in the cracking of the repair material and thereby decrease the flexural stiffness and durability of the repair members. So differential movements between the, that means at the time of applying, it should be, there should not be no any micro pores or pores. Comparing the last point, if it was there, then sure there will be some movements. Okay, so that may result in again cracking of the repair material, so and by decreasing the flexural stiffness and durability of the repair members. So there is no use of taking repair. So that step should be avoided and properly taken care. The degradation in the flexural stiffness of the repaired beams under static and cyclic loading was related to the appearances and development of cracks. So the degradation, the resulting in flexural stiffness. So the beams, normally for the beams in our laboratory, we used to test with static loading and cycling loading, and then only we will take care of the minimum loading condition, maximum loading condition, development of first crack, shear crack, and the final cracks that we normally used to take care. So like this in field also, if the flexural stiffness of the beam getting reduced under those conditions, so the development of cracks will be high or less depending on the usage of the structure. However, the presence of steel fibers within the repair materials may improve resistance against cracking and fatigue resistance. Many researchers nowadays taking care with the help of many fibers, not only steel fibers, n number of fibers has been developed nowadays. So all the fibers we are applying in our concrete to arrest the cracks. Likewise here, what they are explaining is this: the presence of steel fibers in the repair materials, okay, that may improve the resistance against cracking. Yes, because steel fibers have good flexural properties, so it will arrest the cracks. And the last is rehabilitation. It consists of restoring the structure to service level once it had and now lost. Strengthening consists in endowing the structure with a service level higher that initially planned by modifying the structure, not necessarily damaged. So rehabilitation work should be taken care, depends on the repairing works output, or you should decide whether the process of rehabilitation should be carried out for the existing structure, depends on the economical factors and depends on the strength, durability factors, and n number of factors are, these are the important strength, economical and durability factors that should be taken care for the rehabilitation purposes. And by doing rehabilitation, you should not damage the existing structures also, that wherever it is crack free, that is also should not be get disturbed.